This is epic. And welcome. As you can see, it's working nicely. Maybe not the quietest in the world, but certainly usable for lathe work. I mean, a lot of times you're going more like that with the lathe. You're not moving very fast. I want it as quiet as I can get it, obviously. It's best mating. But how did I get here? Well, I messed around with filing and got to the point that was diminishing returns. Wasn't obvious where the hang-ups were on the teeth. And I didn't want to file away a whole bunch of years I didn't need to. So after several false starts, I decided to put the valve lapping compound on it. And it turned pretty tough to start with, but there's still a lot of work to do. I want to make shim washers for in behind there and any place else where the gears might rub against the cases. I need to make shims to shim the case halves apart. General cleanup, of course, with this valve grinding compound on. Every bit of this thing is going into the parts washer. I may even run the gears through the ultrasonic cleaner. But looks like I'm back on the road. I'm just going to show you a few little clips from yesterday when I was finding my way to get here. So there's no point in pointing out which gear teeth are bad to me or whatever because they're fixed already. But you might find it interesting. I'll try to keep it short. See you later. We're checking to see if this shaft is not concentric. Okay, let's grab this wrench fit. Okay, with it tight, we gotta use the wrench. So tick 17. Start over. Okay. Now my question is, if I tighten this up three times in the same orientation, will I get different readings? But it don't look like a bent shaft. And that's the only one that can really bend. Even with the sitting in the bore here, it comes back to within a thousandth. One suggestion was to turn the gears around. Well, this has a shaft going through here, so you can't turn him around. And this is part of the clutch mechanism, so you can't turn that. So that don't work either. Roll it back down. Okay, there's the jam. Putting my finger right past it, right above it. So it's in these teeth right here, and this one has these two both kink that way. I can definitely see that. This one and that one. Let's see. Dark, skip, skip, doo-doo. Is that right? It's easy to see from the other side. Fourth one's the worst.
fourth one's the worst. Third and the fourth, but the fourth is the worst. Okay. First, second, third, fourth, right here. Oh, that's a good view. At least a different one. Okay. I can look at almost every one of those teeth and imagine that it's bent. We can look at how it follows this line. See that winking up to the left? I was advised not to do this, but since we got her to where she will turn through most of the bad spots with some effort, I'm going to put some valve grinding compound. It's not all dried up. There we go. Some valve grinding compound on the areas in question. And with luck, and they'll get over enthused by this. This has worked before. And I've got a nice parts washer with a heater in it. Water-based one over there that I can use to clean up the valve grinding compound. If I keep filing on here, there won't be any gears left. Maybe. Need to run it. Oh, this is strange. Okay, that's one jam right there. And the set screws at about 7 o'clock. No jam at 7. And there's a hard jam at 6, a little before 7. The paste, the grinding paste has jammed it up even more so. It's right at them boogered up teeth. How much do I gotta file off of those suckers before they stop working all together? Doing something a little different, running it out to the outside and seeing if it's that is where the problem is. And I'd have to say yes. Does that actually work? You actually grinding some away? Is that where I cleaned it off? Yeah, it is. Let's go the other way. Now, if this works like valves do, we'll see a polished area where these things are touching. So this will work where the Prussian blue didn't. Thinking pulling the shafts together will simulate the pressure from the, you know, there's so little, makes you wonder why it makes a difference. There's so little movement. Guess it's enough. No, those weren't the goofed up teeth. Goofed up teeth are by that mark. Are they jamming yet? They went right by. Oh, the mark must have moved. You know what? That ain't doing anything. And now we have a mark in there where they are. Let's turn on the parts washer. That was the heater I turned on. Should go through this one. Or not. Oh, it's the bad one. I can mark these enough, polish them enough with the compound, then I can finish them with the file. The Prussian blue probably didn't work because I didn't know what I was doing. I'm sure I'm a real live machinist. Would have figured that out. there's the bad one. I'm running down the edge now. There's something odd in there. Is that my bad one? Yeah, this one before it. There's three in a row right here. This valve grinding compound takes away enough clearance that I can get it to bind without putting the case on, and that's a blessing, I think. Isn't a tooth on this one that's especially bad. See if we can find some periodic. Okay, it's flat with the set screw on the left. And that was at the top. It's at the bottom. Actually, seems this position here is more frequent than the others, but hopefully we'll just grind some surfaces that we can see. If I was set up and experienced in gear cutting, I wouldn't be pissing at this. I'd at least cut a new one of these. That one wouldn't be too hard to make, I don't think. This one, that's a different story. But I would certainly run it through a dividing head. And this does have, we're looking at 14 to 56 teeth, so it's a 4-to-1. So, depending on where you put the thing together, you're going to have different teeth meshing. See, so I'm going to move it off by one tooth, approximately one tooth. And now it's a whole new ball game. Again, one tooth. Two catches per revolution. Direction matters too. Which makes sense since it's a different set of tooth faces. Not even our most booted up gear. I think this is working. Do this. Pretty much got clockwise rotation for the front gear to where it will work, I think. Counterclockwise, not so much. Is it grinding some away, or is it just clearing the grinding compound off? Clockwise, of course, is fine. Thank you. I guess you could say I'm lapping the gears. You know, it's not those beat up teeth you think it would be, but it's not. Dandy, just dandy going that way. Yeah, and I think when they run like this, they tend not to be pushing on each other as hard. You gotta put friction on it to really trust it. And it's working pretty good with friction. Okay, this is encouraging up until now. Okay, I want to continue lapping this, but I want to use the hand wheel to spin it. And so we're going to put it back together a little further than we've been doing up to now. Must be thick. There we go. Where's my oil can? My oil can is empty. And right now it's just faster to do this. Okay, this gear is confusing me. Now it has to connect. Don't use those. It has to connect with this one. Okay, now I got it. There's a front and the back. There, we're getting there. A little love pat. That we'll know when we put it on. Wonderful. And these don't have much wear compared to this guy. Okay, except clutch has to go in first. Yeah, and that's what I was afraid of. Put some of that on here. Let's clean this out.
double sure there is no lapping compound in here. I don't know what it's in here, but outside it's sub 40. We hit freezing last night. Okay, M has to go there. And then the clutch needs to go in, I think. Maybe him, and he drives here. Like that. That's how she goes. The noise you hear in the background is the parts washer warming up. Chuck that one. I want some nice clean towels for this. I don't want to contaminate anything or end up dirty myself. A little on here, a little on here. Now, I believe this one drives, this one rides on the rack on the lathe to move it back and forth, and this one, I believe, catches a gear that runs the cross slide back and forth. And this is where the knob for the half nut goes. And this is the forward, reverse, neutral. And none of those gears are on here right now. Okay, so let's start doing this. Okay. Start applying the branding compound. Roll up the tube toothpaste style. Oh, I want to put the crank on. Put the keyway up so I can see to put it on. Tilt the woodruff key just a little bit. Okay. Now back to applying the valve lapping grinding compound. Can do that with this guy off. See the clutch mechanism here? It's turning now. It was slipping a second before. Little bit into each of them. Looks a little lean here. Okay. And that's a lot of compound I put on there. Maybe too much. I expect it'll jam. With that on there. Are we still recording and are you seeing more than just that oil can? Any answer is yes. It's coming a little bit bigger. Better than I imagined it would. Okay, now we need to put the clutch on, clutch adjuster. And the clutch is doing its thing. is putting that nut on there. Yeah, that does affect it. We'll address the actual working of the clutch later. For now, we just want it locked up. Way too big, and I don't want him falling over. And that looks like about 3/4. Picked up this little 3/4-inch wrench at a garage sale the other day, and I was thrilled to find it. And it is it looks too big. It's actually 11/16, but let's see if that did it. This is kind of bizarre. Before the thing wouldn't, but let me get a proper wrench. I gotta take this apart and see what's going on. I've inadvertently lubricated the clutch. Clutches are left-hand threaded clutch knobs. Okay, let's pull him out. Move this far enough away so it won't fall off the table. Him. Well, now they seem to be locked together for life. Oh, you know, maybe. No, it's slipping. A teeny bit of oil in there. Bet that's what happened. But they're supposed to be oiled from what I hear. Got some off of the shaft. As I said just minutes ago, we'll address the actual functioning of the chuck after we're done with this lapping business. It's amazing how that could have been slipping. Clutch, please. There it is. Little rubbing going on there. And that is not tight. How can it be tight? All this does is pull. How does that even work? Oh, you screw it the other way. It's backwards. Oh, yeah, well, I've never used this. Okay, so let's loosen it. Do that by tightening it. Okay, so this is backwards, so to tighten the clutch, you turn it this way. Yep, yeah, she's grip strong. That makes more sense. Then we're not pulling this gear into the case wall. Okay. Put her back together. Ready to do this with the case off. Till we even going to work this way until we even out the paste. Wonder if I could do that with a Q-tip. This is working nice. The areas that have too much are giving it to the areas that don't have any. Well enough. Oh, this one too now. Okay. See a little better what I'm doing. Trying not to remove it, but to spread it around. Make sure everyone has a slight coating of it. Yeah, see, like it gets shiny like that, taking it off. Okay. One more time, the other direction. No, just the one direction for now. I'm going to put the case on. So the gear don't go flying off again. Okay, that's how that works. This is a sandwich affair. Our life has become a little more complicated. Thank you.
this one seems to be.
No, he's fine.
Okay, now the gear has to come in from this side. Put the keyway up as best I can. Okay, it's pointing that way a bit. Like it. Voila. Okay.
Just go to the outside so I don't crack my hands. Going to be smoother moving away from the chuck. We need some better footage here. Better bits, better bites. This is the way that it turns easy. It's a little less so in this direction, but it's working nice. And just keep doing this for a few more minutes. Catch you back for final, or well, I think this ends the anything interesting on the lapping phase. And I think this ends anything interesting on the lapping phase. Yeah. You're a good kitty. You're a good kitty cat. Should we go? Should we go? Come on. Let's go. Go.
So why are you coming to see me? Hmm? Yeah, come on. Don't be slow. Yeah. Are you out of food?